A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we are indeed blessed and honored to have with us tonight our dear brother Shaffieq, Mohamed Shaffieq, and we are grateful for him to spend some time with us as we've completed the first week of Ramadan. We're now into the second day of the second week, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so much to reflect on and to think about. And we know that the main goal of Ramadan is so that we may become part of al-muttaqun, part of the pious, counted amongst those that have piety, that have God consciousness. But we also know that Ramadan is the month of the Qur'an. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us and He informs us in the Qur'an that indeed He revealed the Qur'an in this month so that it is a form of guidance for us. The Qur'an is guidance for us. And so our connection with the Qur'an and the success or outcomes that we desire for Ramadan are intertwined and intricately linked. So tonight we're honored again to have Dr. Mohamed Shaffieq, who will be talking to us a little bit about our connection with the Quran. And we're again honored to have him with us. So without further ado, I'd ask Dr. Shaffieq to address us. Dr. Shaffieq.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. All thanks and praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek His mercy, His blessings, and we beg for His forgiveness. I testify to the absolute fact that there is no deity, no one worthy of any deification except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He's indeed alone and has no partners. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can lead astray. And whomsoever He left to wander, none can provide guidance to. And I bear witness that Muhammad ibn Abdullah Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is indeed the last and final messenger. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He was sent as a mercy, as a compassion, as a benefactor, as an intercessor for all of humanity في يوم القيامة. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam and guests, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Indeed, this is a month of Qur'an. It is a month where approaching the Qur'an in the proper way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّكُونَ. He didn't say, لِتَتَّكُونَ. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّكُونَ is perhaps maybe we shall attain taqwa. We may come in this state of consciousness, of cognizance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But before I begin that, we all know that the Qur'an as believers is a miracle. It's the miracle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We know that the Qur'an is a shifa. We know that the Qur'an is a hidayah. It is a guidance. We know that the Qur'an is the last revealed scripture that sent to mankind with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the teacher of that scripture, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem. But I want to, before I begin, bring the style of the Qur'an to you, how beautiful the Qur'an is put together. Many critics of Islam would say the Qur'an, it is randomly put together, that it is a non-linear book. And many times we refer to the Qur'an as chapter 1 and chapter 2, but there's no chapter in the Qur'an, it is surah, because when you think of chapters, you're thinking that something in a chronological order, like chapter one, you have to read chapter one in order to understand chapter two. The Quran is not a chapter book. It is a surah, and there is nothing like it. For example, the Quran, the first few revelation of the Quran is in Surah 696. The first, you would think that would be in the first surah, but it's in Surah 96. The second set of revelation is in Surah 68. And the third set of revelation to the Prophet ﷺ is in Surah 73. But yet, what we see, it is a perfect, it's a perfect order, a very sophisticated, perfect order of the Qur'an. There's something called the ring composition. So the topic tonight will be mostly on Surah Al-Baqarah. So let's use Surah Al-Baqarah to demonstrate this perfect order of the Qur'an, which is called a ring composition. And a ring composition is that the first statement or the first page or the first sentence should have a corresponding relationship with the last. And that corresponding relationship should be either a repeating word or a striking word should mirror the last. So the first should mirror the last. And the second surah or the second chapter or the second statement should mirror the second to last. And then what's happening, you're forming a ring, but I would like to change that word for a moment. And
let's call it a wheel.
And this wheel, it has outer rings. And let's draw a line through the hub of this wheel. And the center of this hub is the subject matter
of this surah.
So Surah Al-Baqarah, it begins with the believer, the muttaqin. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alif Lam Mim,
ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ
هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. So taqwa begins with Baqarah. It's not wait until 183 of taqwa. It begins. But it begins in a very interesting way. It begins to call the practitioner of taqwa a muttaqin. That a person who embodies this state of consciousness is called a muttaqin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately refer to muttaqin, then we immediately begin to elaborate what is the quality of a muttaqin. Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. That the one of the embodiment, one of the conviction of the muttaqin is to believe in the unseen. And it's interesting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
begins with this first, this quality, rather than salah or zakah. He says that the first embodiment of cognizant of Allah is that you must believe in the unseen.
Science today has proven
that only 4% of the entire creation man can actually see, can measure, can explain. 96% we cannot see.
That is a scientific fact. Now the people of
Tasawwuf, the spiritual people of Islam, they say
interestingly that most of the thing that we believe we don't see. And when we do see something,
we have a different interpretation of that same thing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, one who embodies this
cognizance of Allah
is the one that who believes in the unseen.
And what remains unseen for us
was made seen for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Miraj. So what remains unseen for us, ghaib, was made seen to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That makes him a better teacher of what to follow in these pages of Al-Quran Al-Kareem. So the first of Surah Al-Baqarah talks about from
the first ayah
to ayah 20, it covers the believer, then it went to the disbeliever, then it went to the hypocrite. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the next ring in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuha an-nasu ubudu rabbakum alladhi.
And it's interesting, when he begins this next section, it begins
also with taqwa.
But this taqwa is for all of mankind.
So Ramadan, attaining taqwa through fasting is not unique, only through fasting. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to the second ring of Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha an-nasu ubudu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum walladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Almost the same ayah of when he talks about fasting, but here it's addressed to all of mankind. That, O mankind, Ya ayyuha an-nasu ubudu, if you worship Allah as those before you,
you mi'atin la'allakum tattaqun. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start talking about the creation of Adam alayhi salam. And then the next ring, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went into details about the previous nation, about the Bani Israel, delivering the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Bani Israel, furuni ni'mati allati an'amtu. And he begins to talk about the laws that he legislated for the previous nation. And he went into details, almost 63 ayahs into the detail. And then the next ring before, this is just before the center of the hub. And you know, it's interesting. It is always good to be in the hub of a ring or a wheel, because it is that place which brings quietude in the middle of the hub. Like you always hear that when there's a hurricane, the safest place to be in a hurricane is in the eye of a hurricane. And I want you to keep this in mind, because I'm going to come to the subject matter, which is in the hub of Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins now, just before coming to the hub, he start talking about Ibrahim alayhi salam. About Ibrahim, he was hanifa wa ma kana min al mushrikeen, that he never associated partner to Allah. And he is the one that is the father of Ismail and Ishaq, that we are all coming from one father, the father of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim. And it's interesting that in this month of Ramadan, we're not only celebrating, and this is one of the beauty of Quran, it's inclusiveness, that we're celebrating all the revealed scriptures. Because on the 1st of Ramadan, the book of Ibrahim was revealed to Ibrahim. And on the 6th of Ramadan, the Torah was revealed to Musa alayhi salam. On the 13th of Ramadan, the Injil was given to Isa alayhi salam. And on the 12th of Ramadan, the Zabur was given, so that was revealed in this month of Ramadan. So it shows the inclusiveness of Ramadan, that we are celebrating all the revealed scriptures with special emphasis of Al-Quran al-Kareem. So the ring before the subject matter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about Ibrahim, about Yaqub, that Yaqub in his dying bed, he's asking his son, who will you worship after I'm gone? He's concerned about the theology of his son, not concerned about the wealth or the inheritance. He's saying just before he loses his life, al-maut comes, he says, I am concerned about the theology of my children. So he asks them specifically, who will you worship after I'm gone? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about the test of Ibrahim. وَإِذْ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ. And he went into the very detail of the test of Ibrahim, that he tried Ibrahim with so many tests. And the middle of Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about what he did to establish this month of Ramadan, is the establishment of this new ummah. And how he began to establish this new ummah, it is in the subject matter of Baqarah.
It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةٌ وَسَّتَ.
That you, this ummah is a middle nation. You're not of any extreme. You are not an extremist nation. You're a nation of a middle path. And just before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about Ramadan, the first subject matter before he comes into this hub of this ring, he changed the capital of the Bani Israel, the people before, the capital of Rasulullah, and this is 14 years into Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is standing in Medina, but he would face Al-Aqsa for Salah. Just before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about Ramadan, the first thing he did is to redirect the capital. The capital is no more Aqsa, no Mecca. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina would change his direction and turn to Mecca to pray.
Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of the laws that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about in Baqarah, and the telling them that they must come and they do not deviate and you do not treat your messenger like this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begin to say that you are the follower of Abraham, but you are a different ummah from Bani Israel.
You are similar because you come from the teachings of Ibrahim alayhi salam,
but now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begin to distinguish this ummah. And this is happening, alhamdulillah, in Ramadan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first thing he declared is a new capital.
Now, if you're declaring a new capital, and the leader of this new nation is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then any nation needs a constitution. And now it is the Quran al-Kareem become the constitution. Now, we are in the middle of the wheel. If you start going now to the out of the wheel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a perfect
symmetry. He begin to talk now about the Muslim will be tested.
Just like Ibrahim will be tested. And then we have the subject. Now he is talking about the Muslim will be tested. It's a perfect mirror, a symmetry. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about the Muslim being tested now. And he says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ مِنَ الْأَقْصِ وَالْأَمْوَالِ وَأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. And this is an ayah. It's amazing that the Muslim is being tested. This is an ayah of relevance today of what we are seeing across the globe. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ, that he will test you, the Muslim. And what will he test you first and foremost with? With fear. With fear. And it's interesting that Allah begins with fear, because what drives this plague, first and foremost, we're in a state of fear. That is why we are locked down. We are in a state of extreme fear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did something very beautifully here. He says, بِشَيْءٍ. You see, if he didn't put that disclaimer in there, that is between وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ and خَوْفٍ, then we will be in a constant state of fear, like what we are in here now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I'm only trying you with a little bit, something of fear. And the next thing he said he is trying you with, مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ. And look what the fear is driving us to. We are becoming very irrational. We talk about al-ghaib, about the muttaqeen. One of the things is of al-ghaib now is this virus, which is 13 nanobase. The eyes cannot see it. But I don't have to explain what it is to you. Like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the Quran, he says, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. No Quran is mentioned. He says, we sent it down. We all know what it is. It is al-Quran. Now I can say, you see what's going on. What is it? We know this it is the virus because it predominates our life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he will test you. It's there, right in Baqarah, right next to the hub, the subject matter of Baqarah. He says, first he will test you with fear, and fear will drive you into hunger. And the next thing he says, you will lose your wealth. Look what we're seeing today. Stimulus package. We have ICNA was distributing food in the Bronx yesterday, and there was a massive looting. People were just picking food up in a state of hunger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he will test you with fear, something of fear, not extreme fear. Like when he saves us from extreme fear. But when he tests us with a little bit of fear. When he says, لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْشِ إِلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. He says, الَّذِي أَتْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. The tanween implicates that it's extreme fear he's saving you from. But when he tests you with مِنَ الْخَوْفِ كَسْرَة, that just little bit of fear. Look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he saves us from extreme situation. And when he do test us, he tests us just with little bit. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he tests you with fear, then he will test you with hunger, with losing your wealth, and he will test you next with a loss of life. Look how many lives we've seen lost within our community. I work in the hospital, you see. I was privileged the other day to recite Surah Yasin on one of the patients before they removed the ventilator from her. And there was no family member there. It was just me and the nurse. And I was privileged to have the time to recite Surah Al-Yasin. And this really shook me up and bring me into the reality that we're living in this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he will test you with the loss of life. And the next thing he says, was-thamarat, with the loss of fruits. And we are worried today. Look at the suicide rate among our younger generation. It just went up in the Queens area. An article was published a couple of days ago. The suicide rate among the younger people is skyrocketing. So this is the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start talking about the test of us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes in the ring, and the last of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about believer and unbelief, and that corresponds to the first of the ayah. Now, because of time, I'm going to go just quickly into the actual ayah about Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala interestingly says that when he begin to talk about Ramadan, he says that as-siyam ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba alal ladina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun, that this siyam, it is from kataba, from the passive verb, that is written for you, it has been legislated to you, that this siyam la'allakum tattaqun, that perhaps maybe he didn't say litattaqun. Litattaqun would be a lamb of consequence, meaning that if you fast consequentially, you will attain taqwa. He didn't say that. He says, la'allakum tattaqun, maybe, perhaps. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to talk about the previous nation, that the way they used to fast. He says, ayyamu ma'dudat, that they only used to fast a few days. Ma'dudat is a minimal plural, meaning that they fast between 3 to 9 days. And this is the merit of the Quran. We see that the Nasara and the Jews, they fast only for a few days. They don't fast for the entire month. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَيَّامَ مَعْدُودَةً فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيدًا أَوْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ فَإِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُتِيكُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ تُعَامُ مِسْكِينَ. And you're exempt from fasting if you're sick or if you're traveling. You make up the fasting on light days. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts another option for the people before us. He says, وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُتِيكُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ تُعَامُ مِسْكِينَ. You have an additional option. If you don't want to fast and you want to opt out from fast, then you pay the fidya. And it says, to'amu miskin. You're giving the food of the miskin. You're not doing them a favor. He didn't say, it'amu miskin, that you're feeding them. He says, to'amu miskin, that you're giving them the food. But he concludes this ayah very interestingly. He says, faman tatawwa'a khayran fahuwa khayrun lahu wa antasumu khayrun lakum in kuntum ta'alamun. That if you know what is best for you, you will forego all of that and you will fast. And he finished talking about the previous nation, and now he turned to us for the first time, and the first time he will use Ramadan in the entire Quran. And when he used Ramadan, it is not directly with fasting, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ, that this month of Ramadan, it is about Al-Quran al-Kareem. And what is about this Qur'an al-Kareem? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this Qur'an al-Kareem, it is hudal lin-nas. He begins to differentiate the Qur'an itself from the previous nation, that the Torah was for a specific people. It was for Bani Israel. Wa Injil was for the Nasara. But this is different now for you guys. This Qur'an al-Kareem is for hudal lin-nas. It is for all of mankind. And then when you take this message to mankind, they will ask you, where did you get this from? Allah answers next. He says, وَبَيِّنَاتِ مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ. Tell them that the indisputable proof, the clear proof, the truth is in the Quran itself. And then the third benefit of the Quran in this month of Ramadan, it is Al-Furqan. It is now this Quran will decide what is pure from impure. And it's interesting that before Islam, thousands of years before Islam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he made a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about this Quran. And exactly the three things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this Quran came from, it is from the dua of Ibrahim, when Ibrahim alayhi salam says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّنَا وَبَأَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَيُزَكِيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتُ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. He says, oh Allah, send in them, from them, a messenger who will recite this Quran, who will yatlu. Yatlu come from tilawa. And there is no equivalent in English for this word yatlu, recite. Because yatlu come from tilawa. Tilawa means to follow. So inherently, if you recite the Quran, it is obligatory upon you to follow what you're reciting. It is not a book, oh, I'm going to read it, and if something is interesting, I will practice it. It's not that's with the Quran. The Quran is yatlu alayhim ayatika
وَيُعَلِّهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ, that we read the Qur'an in this month of Ramadan, we recite it, we learn it, and we extrapolate the hikmah, and this is the form of purification. The Prophet ﷺ, he was sent to mankind for this exact purpose, to teach us the Qur'an, to recite it to us, to teach it to us, and to teach us the hikmah, and that will purify us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month of Ramadan bless us that we can recite the Qur'an, we can reflect upon the Qur'an, we can ponder upon the Qur'an. It is a month of first and foremost about Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this Qur'an, it is different from all the previous scripture. This Qur'an is for all of mankind. And in this month of Ramadan, it is not the shaitan is chained from the Muslim. It is from all of mankind. So the heart of everyone is receptive to the Qur'an. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala imbibe in us the courage and the discipline to dispense the message of Al-Quran Al-Kareem in the month of Ramadan. I wanted to talk more about the rest of the ayah, but alhamdulillah, we will do this some other time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed all of us to enter into the second week of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us, like he says, وَلِتُؤْمِنُوا الْإِدَّةِ, we will count the days. And when we finish count the days, we will declare that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest. وَقُولِي قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ. Thank you, my dear brothers and sisters, for listening.
Jazakumullah khairan, our dear brother Mohamed Shaffieq. Alhamdulillah, he has given us so much to reflect on and think about in the context of the Quran and the hub that is in Surah Al-Baqarah that he talked about, and the reflections in terms of not just reciting the Quran but also putting it into practice. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to reward our dear brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and protect his family and grant them the best of this world and the best of the hereafter. Ameen. Indeed, we also want to recognize and thank Dr. Shaffieq and all of the frontline workers, whether you're in medicine or you are in transit or you are in police or fire, you are working at a grocery store. So many of our frontline workers are there providing and putting themselves at risk. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them and help them and grant them guidance if they are not yet Muslims, so that they may become Muslims, inshallah.
Ameen, ya Rabbi.
Ameen. I just before I end, I want to just remind everybody on two things. Again, in keeping in context with the Quran and Ramadan being the month of the Quran, on Mondays and on Wednesdays, we have our Quran verse spotlight, where we will release some videos of certain passages of the Quran. These are selected passages that we think has some impact or has something if we were to reflect on it. And we ask you to just respond back to us on Facebook or on YouTube with something that you are thinking about in your reflections on that particular passage or verse. Also on Fridays, we have our Quran scavenger hunt. Alhamdulillah, we had our first one released last Friday. The next one, as well as the answers from the first one, will be coming on this Friday, inshallah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to again protect us and allow us to complete the month of Ramadan, allow us to witness Allahumma balighna laylatul qadr, witness the night of power as we enter into the last 10 nights in the future, inshallah. So we close. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik wa ashhadu an la ilaha ant wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk wal asr innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilus salihat wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.